Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean, Legend of Heroes, Blind, and stuff. We can go to the ship now, maybe, but let's just check to see if anyone's around. Maybe they all went to the ship. Principal Forgin saying good morning from don't know where from. Ah. Hi, Principal, says Forte. I managed to finish transcribing the musical score. Thank you very much. Forte was handed a musical score of Forest and Sea Memory. You look like you haven't slept a bit, says Una. Don't worry, my entire body is brimming with a sense of satisfaction. I can easily fight off drowsiness. Hey, Principal, says Forte. You catch cold sleeping in a place like this. Oh, I must have dozed off. Well, see you later. I look forward to today's performance, too. McBain says he's so pumped up.
Pumped, man. We're pumped.
There was another intruder, although this time it wasn't my fault. This is the private room of Mr. Rish. You can't go in. I thought we were about to have a nice little conversation, and you just... back to that. So I can see there's nobody in these rooms. I didn't have to go in all of them. Let me out. Oh. I didn't check these. Oh, these guys are here. Last night's dinner tasted a little bland. I expected something better for our last dinner. Jeez, he's getting spoiled over there. My master didn't like last night's meal. He was so upset and has been giving me a lot of trouble. He can hear you, you know. Alright, something's up with last... Did we eat last night's meal? Because we have nothing to say about it. Check around the roof. All the slats have been put back. Where was it again? Here? Hmm. It doesn't work. I don't want to go in there. Let's see if there's anyone at the ambassador's building. Mayor Holsto says, there was some noise coming from upstairs yesterday. Was there a spring cleaning or something? How are we supposed to know anything about spring cleanings? Well, there's no one in the kitchen now. No one in these beds? Okay. That guy's there. Why doesn't this room have a door? Mr. Rish has boarded the banquet. Then get out of our way. He requires your services. She has to say. May I have your attention? The Grumble, the ferry to Polka, will arrive soon. Other contestants will leave on this ferry. Would you like to see them off? McBean says, who wants to see Shao off? Okay. Alright, before we advance to the docks, let me just take another look around. Another look around the beaches and stuff to see if anyone's down in the casino, and then there's that other shop. Would it be in front of it? She never says anything. Yeah, I don't think these people would say anything. The lead chef terminated his contract and went back. It's a headache. What should we do? Okay, there's something. McBain says, so they think he resigned. It's been covered up, Una says. The resignation of the lead chef got me thinking. I should think about my future, too. I don't think there's anyone. Oh, what's his name's here? DeMille. I don't have enough time today, so I'll gamble only a little bit. Actually, you don't have enough money, right? Asked Forte. Mayor DeMille is weeping silently. Damn you, Rish! You trapped us! It's not true, says Una. Why is it not true? Because the true evil is from the pirates. Well, let's talk to these people and then we'll go to the docks. Well, I can't make up my mind, Mr. Thea says. A typical souvenir would be a sword or shell armor, right? I don't think so, Forte says. She's still buying souvenirs. Miss Marito says, the items they have here, don't you think they really have a bad taste? I would display something more stylish and fashionable, something that attracts women. Rish may be a successful merchant, but he surely overlooked the souvenirs. Alright, let's go to the boat. I guess it's docked over here. Let me just take a quick look down here first. There was someone standing over here. Just curious if they still are here and what they might say. Oh, there's a whole bunch of people. Oh, wow. So wait, all the people we're supposed to talk to are over here. I thought they would be over here. Let's talk to them. If you ever come to Gavaro, do visit the International Theater. Una says, by the way, Forte, you'll be performing at the theater next year, right? Yes, next year. Really? Says Wendy, you must have won the Pinsel recital. No wonder you won the audition. I can't wait to see you play at the Grand Hall of the International Theater. Balthazar says, the trip to Riotime Island was very, very fruitful. We were able to make friends with great troubadours like you. McBain says, Forte, Una, it's our turn to visit Cavaro and learn about the spirit of first-class performers who play at the International Theater. That's right, says Forte. Balthazar says once I get back to Gavaro, I must train myself really hard. Rachel says, well, it was a pretty good vacation. I don't mind coming back here once again. I should bring my swimsuit with me the next time. Xiao. Oh, Master, you came to see me off? Thank you for everything. If we ever meet somewhere, I might ask for your help again. You take care of yourselves too, kid, says McBean. It's a picture-perfect moment, says Xiao. You've been really strict with us, but you really are a kind person, Master. Just don't do anything mischievous in March Rose, okay? What do you mean? You don't trust us? Master, you can do better to encourage your disciple who is down after losing the huge prize money. Like giving me 10,000 gents as a farewell gesture? Don't go overboard. Argus, you're troubadours, right? If you ever visit Ostern during your tour, please stop by Selbart Village. We'll do that, says Forte. The audition was quite fun. I want to do something like that again. Una says, everyone performs, sings, and dances. If you ever visit Ostern during your tour, please come to Selbart Village in the desert. My grandmother would be happy to have you. Okay, that's it. Oh, wait. We got him. Even if I get back to Graysoul, I can't work as long as the swing gang is there. I have no choice but to go to March of Rose. You don't know, says Forte. The swing gang was arrested. Is it so? Now I should go back to Graysoul and work there doing low-key jobs. Ooh. Forte, that's actually startled me. Forte says, look, the ship has arrived. I wonder if we had been able to get on before we talked to all those people. Rachel says, Forte, Una, good luck with your performance at the party on the ship. Thanks, says Una. You take care too, Rachel. Forte says, we should play together someday. Yeah, I look forward to it. Woof! Nothing from the rat this time. Hi. Grumble Captain says, hi, you all. I heard. You won the first prize. Congratulations. Forte says, we picked the right tune. We played Forest and Sea Memory. Captain says, oh, by the way, have you seen Roland? Huh? Yeah, we saw him. Did you? He must be busy. Usually he comes to see me right after the ship arrives. Una says, he must prepare all that food for the party on the ship. He must be busy. They don't want to tell him he's captured. Yeah, right. Good day, everyone. Una says, we couldn't tell him that Roland was captured. We must rescue him, says Forte. Let's get on to the banquet. Well, you put me all the way back here, and now I gotta run all the way back. You people. Finally getting on this boat. Not quite. McBain says, wait, Forte, Una. What is it, Grandpa? I'm sure you both know that it's up to us to save the guests and Roland. We can't avoid a fight or two. Are you prepared for this? What happens if we say no? Forte says, but if you emphasize it like that, I became a little nervous. Should we check our equipment again, says Una. McBain says, we still have time before the ship leaves. We can spar with the crabs. Wait, if I go try to go backwards. Oh, okay. Yes. Don't worry, says Una. That's good, McBain says. Ambassador Guerrero says, hi, everyone. Good morning. Good morning, says Forte. We are waiting for you. Slade told me everything. Slade? Says Una. Is he already on board? Yes. He's so organized and quick. I take my hat off. He got out of the room first thing in the morning, saying that he needs to check things out beforehand. He told me to tell you not to worry. He should be back before the ship leaves. Right. He seems sure-footed, says McBain. Here's the chairman. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? The preparations for the party are now finished. The banquet will leave in a few moments. Please enjoy your voyage until we get to the party site. A whistle of departure echoed in the air, and the two outer wheels of the banquet began turning stalwartly. Trying to picture a stalwart turn. The banquet set off to sea and began gliding on the water surface briskly. Ryutam Island faded into the distance as the ship sailed further and further out to sea. Well, hopefully we have the strength to win the fights that are to come. Elise says, the banquet is now heading toward the Prima Islands. It will take a while before we arrive at the scheduled spot. Until then, please enjoy a pleasant journey on the side wheel steamer banquet. What is it? Says Forte. We can't find Roland on the ship. The lead chef is not on the ship hosting the party. It's strange, isn't it? By the way, they say he didn't show up in the kitchen yesterday. Don't worry, says McBain. He'll show up tomorrow as if nothing had happened. I hope so, too. I'm sorry to have bothered you. It will take a while before we arrived at the scheduled spot. How is he going to catch the ship and arrive tomorrow? Until then, please sit back and relax. Alright, let me save the game. Okay. Attention! Let's jump off! Is Berea, whatever. Oh, no, Eton. They look the same. How do you feel about the ride? It doesn't shake at all. You're right, says Una. I feel as if I was standing on the ground. The pair of wheels thrust through the waves and keep the hull in balance. Wheels? The stability is a key feature of a side-wheel steamer. Oh, he's the one that's, like, really into boats. Chuckling. I have accomplished one of my ambitions. This time I enjoyed Rish's banquet to my heart's content. There are many other ships I want to see. Such as? Says Forte. First, I want to see Pirate King Ramon's Black Dragon. It's a sailboat, but they say the Black Dragon is a battleship equipped with tremendous mobility and speed. I haven't heard any news about it lately, so the ship may have sunk. No, we're about to be attacked by it, I'm sure. Then there's another ship called White Eagle of the Ocean. It's the Planetos 2 of Captain Thomas. This one has too many legends, and I don't even know if it actually exists. Wasn't the Planetos, the first one, just called Planetos from Tear of a Million? Previous game? Alright, there's the stairs down. And there's here, which also has stairs down. Well, hi. Steersman says, it's going to be a grand party. If everything goes as planned, we may be able to treat ourselves to a feast. What do you mean, everything goes as planned, says McBain. Ah, well, it's nothing. By the way, this area is off limits. Turn around and go back. Well, that changed quickly. Alright, Which stairs? Oh, that's not a stairs going down. It's the stairs up to here. Never mind. Alright, so we have one way to go. And that is here, if I can get in. There's another floor down there. Elise says, Roland hasn't showed up, so we switched to a buffet. This way, we only need to prepare simple appetizers and make the guests happy. Where are you, Roland? What are you doing? Chairman says, they're short of hands in the kitchen, so I offered to help. But I can only arrange tableware or things like that. Being an apprentice, he's doing well. Apprentice chef says, don't talk to me, I'm busy. Forte says, it seems he is in a war or something. I'm as busy as a bee. Please get out of the way. You don't want to end up in a soup pot, do you? Yes, we will become one with your soup pot. Alright, crowds of people hanging around. Mayor Holsto says, the bad blood between these two is famous in Martyros. It's interesting, though. When the crisis hit Cavaro, they made a truce and fought together. Maybe there are actually kindred spirits. I feel the same, says Forte. Mayor says, as long as these two are around, Cavaro will be safe. Miss Marito says, if we can give out the second prize, it should go to Wendy. It's not even a joke, says Mayor DeMille. No one deserves a second prize better than Balthazar. It's Wendy, she says. Out of the question, it's Balthazar. They're so worked up, says Una. Maybe they actually like each other, says Forte. You're the mayor of the City of Art. How can you have such a poor ability to appreciate music? I'm concerned about the future of Cavaro. You can't tell a good performance from a bad one as the head of an entertainment company. There's no future for the Maritos group. Wow. Pretty cold there. No future for Maritos. Principal Forgin saying nothing. Forte says, are you okay, Principal? What's wrong with me? I stayed up all night to transcribe the musical score, but I shouldn't... I won't be able to even wake up. Forte supposedly says, yeah, that seems to be an error. I can't sleep until I hear your performance. I look forward to today's performance again. Play that by me again. Alright. Barion, there he is. The lead chef who's been working with us until yesterday seems to have resigned. I'm so disappointed. Oh, so it was the apprentice who made last night's dinner. Carano says, I can't find Slade in the cabin. He may not be on board. He's a smart guy, says Forte. He shouldn't have made such a mistake. McBain says, he said not to worry, so we should trust him. Carano says, Rish and Borrega are in the cabin downstairs. They must be designing a sinister plan. McBain says, we can listen to the voices in the next cabin from here. Bregger says, what's our next move? Rish says, when we come to the Prima Islands, a performance will begin on the boat to kick off the party. It'll be the signal for Ramon to appear on his black dragon and attack the banquet. Your aim is only to scare people. Don't sink the boat, will you? The Black Dragon will pull alongside the anchored banquet. Then you and I will move to the Black Dragon as hostages. I'm counting on your good acting. As the representative of the Numerous Empire, I shall make a formal objection to the pirates. As a victim, of course. Ramon will then demand ransom and collect money from all over the world. Pirate King Ramon is the only villain here. What a sly old fox. Forte says, it's just as Slade has told us. Luna says, if we expose their plan now, no one will be taken hostage. It's not an option, says McBean. If the plane is exposed, Ramon will stop attacking. If the pirate ship doesn't come, we can't rescue Roland. True. Forte says, but if they do come attacking, we can't deal with them ourselves. Don't worry, says McBean. We have help. Don't we, Slade? What? Says Forte. Where? Says Una. Oh, jeez. I'm impressed, Slade says. I thought I hid myself pretty well. It was your cologne. I just remember the last time, McBean says. I was confident you were around again. Slade says, now that we know about the plan, there's only one thing you should do. What is it? Says Una. Call for backups. See you later. We don't have backups. We're at sea. And then he closes the door. Forte says, backups? On the open sea? Says Una. We'll get out of here too, says McBean. Now we're gonna get out of here. Door is locked, okay. The door stayed open till we worked back. Oh, never mind. It was weird, we walked past it and it closed. See? I walk up to it and it closes. See if they have anything different to say. My name's not Roland. Yeah, they got this dastardly plan, that's right. That's gonna save again. Because we've been talking to a lot of people. Just in case we unexpectedly get in some kind of battle and die. I mean, I don't know. You can tell the steersman, maybe? Oh, there's people over there now. Nah, he's just yelling at us about off limits. Slade says, go, pigeon! Is that calling for backup? Jan barking. Forte says, hey, it's a carrier pigeon. Guerrero says, I didn't know Buridane had such an advanced intelligence system. We'll have our backup soon, says Slade. Cool. Who will be our backup? Asks Forte. Guerrero says, it's a top secret. They're not telling anyone. Let's set our plan first, McBean says. Slade says, the sailor in the pirate room is a pirate henchman of Ramon. I'll take care of him myself. Ambassador Guerrero, you're in charge of guiding the guests. With your instructions, the guests will stay calm. All right. What about us, Grandpa? We'll intercept the pirates. Whenever we have a chance, we'll get aboard Ramon's pirate ship and rescue Roland. We'll be arriving at the scheduled spot shortly. It's almost the time for the party. I look forward to a superb performance. Well, we can't get to Gareno. Go that way. The whistle sounds different when you listen to it close by. I may just apply for a crew member's position. I know this is the state-of-the-art ship, but how come there's only one crew member? Don't you have to go back and play music or something? Don't screw up our schedule. What schedule, says Forte? Of course, the schedule for the attack, the party, I mean. Anyhow, go back quickly and start your performance on the stage. I don't want to do that. Now let's see what else Gareno might have to say. Whew! It's the first real test since I became a diplomat. I'm really nervous. Miss Ripthea says, it's strangely cold for this time of year. I feel something is not right. Is a storm approaching? Or it may be something worse, Forte says, smiling. I have very good senses. I seldom guess wrong. It's evil coming our way. Oh, I was supposed to talk to her. Okay. Would you like to practice on the stage? Asked Elise. It will take some time before the party starts. We must place food first. McBain says, we can play some simple pieces until the party starts. That's a good idea. Please entertain the guests. Forte, Una, are you ready for solos? What they say? I just like to see what they say when they say no. Forte says, well, I want to look around inside the ship a little more. We'll be waiting, says Elise. Yes. Okay, I can start, says Forte. The first program is a solo performance by Una, says McBean. Here I am. I'm ready, Grandpa Mac. Playful birds, Una with her piccolo. Before the party began on the ship, Una gave a solo performance with her piccolo, and Forte played as Cathara alone. When their performances ended, the food was ready and the guests were seated at their tables. McBain says, the banquet has begun. Banquet on the banquet. Let's do our best to entertain the guests. Yeah, says Forte. Yes, Una says. Traveler's Prelude by the McBain Company. Thank you very much, McBain says. Una says, Forte, one of the people talking with Rish over there is Slade. What? One of the people talking with Rish over there is Slade? Okay, so Slade's talking to Rish, is what you're trying to say? In your strange way? Forte says, what are they talking about? Smiling. McBain says, he has some nerve talking to him and gathering information directly. Right, the next piece. Open your mind. Thank you very much, says McBain. Okay, hold on a second. Okay. The delectable dishes are getting cold. Please eat while listening to our music. You're asking these people to multitask now. Why isn't Ramon attacking us yet? Whispers Forte. I'm getting nervous. It became windy, says McBain. If his pirate ship is to attack us, they should come from the windward direction. Elise says, you all did a good job. Why don't you take a rest? Thank you, but we'd rather continue with our performance. Una says, listen, Elise, whatever happens, don't be surprised. Yeah. Surprised by what? You'll find the answer soon, says Forte. By that. It's begun, says McBain. Miss Merito says, what's going on? Mayor Halsto saying, what the hell? Heavens, it's a pirate ship. Wow, says Eton, it's so cool. What are you talking about? Miss Ripthea says. Gareno says, everyone please calm down. McBain says, they're just threatening us, so those cannonballs won't hit the ship. Elise says, the pirate we saw the other day. Oh, they're just, like, warning shots? Yeah, they're supposed to just scare us. Something tells me they're gonna do more than that, though.